Alright, so flight testing is done. We had a very successful set of maiden flights with this guy, and I'm gonna take this time to go ahead and explain this system with a little bit more detail. So again, this is the Tasmanian version 2. This is the Octo configuration. And let me go ahead and apologize for my voice. I've come down with a little bit of a cold. So if I start hacking up a lung right in the middle of the video, I apologize. I can't help it. Anyway, this is the Octo configuration of the Tasmanian version 2. We're also going to be selling this in a standard config where you've got 4 ESCs instead of 8 and 4 motors instead of 8, and you use the big motors on the ends of the arms. Most people are going to run 12S with that particular type of setup. So why did we produce this? Well, we are always striving to get the most performance that we can out of these X-Class systems, okay? And so because we can't reduce the size of the machine, what we've done here is attempted to make this thing as light as possible. And this thing is very light. So the bare frame all by itself without any of the electronics installed is right at about 600 grams. So as far as I know, that is probably the lightest or one of the lightest in the industry, okay? Now, this particular configuration, the Octo, the reason you would want to run this particular configuration is this is unbelievably agile, okay? So what we're doing here is we're taking the mass and we're moving it in as far as we can towards center. So instead of running a big motor out on the ends of the arm, we are splitting that motor into two and moving one inboard and obviously running two props, okay? So your inertia is drastically reduced in this type of configuration. So what that translates into, if you know anything about physics, is that it's going to perform better. It's the same theory as is used, or same technique that is used in car development, so auto racing. The reason that the high-end manufacturers like Ferrari, Audi, and now Chevrolet, if you can believe that, with their C8 Corvette, are moving the engines in towards center. It's called a mid-engine. The reason they do a mid-engine design is to keep the inertia, everything, all the mass, centrally located. That helps performance. It's no different with these quads, all right? Now, additionally, this system here has comparable thrust that you're going to be producing with a 12S system using big motors and 13-inch props. It's around the same. It's a little bit less, but it's pretty comparable. And you're doing that with less money. So the batteries that we're running on this thing are these. These are 5,000 mAh. Let me see if I can flip this thing over without messing things up here. Okay. These are 5,000 milliamp hour 8S packs. These are really cheap and they're used in RC cars. So they're plentiful. They've been around for a long time and they work really well with this particular setup. Okay. The motors are inexpensive as well. So these are just Brother Hobby, these are 2812 690 kV. These are like 30 bucks a pop. So each arm you're spending 60 bucks on motors. The ESCs are APD, 8S capable, 100 amp ESCs. Okay, those come in at about 80 bucks a pop. So you're spending a little bit more on the cumulative price for the ESCs compared to a 12S setup, but you're far outweighing it with the price of your batteries, which is substantially less. It's less than half the cost for this type battery. The props are less expensive. The motors are less expensive. This frame is less expensive than our version 1 Tasmanian. And so this system is something, if you are running a track, okay, if you're a track racer and you fly X-Class, this is going to be the option for you if you want something that is low price and extremely agile, okay? And you've got to do a lot of cornering, you've got to get through gates and turn this thing around and get to the next gate quickly. So that pretty much sums up the Octo Tasmanian. And the next build we do with this thing, we have another frame ready to go and all the components to build up a more typical quad configuration with 12S and all that goodness. And so our next video will be flight testing that guy.
Guys, that thing flies so good. Just the sound of it alone, you can tell just how smooth it is flying through the air. It's so amazing.
All right, motor temps are good. I was really on it too, okay?
Yeah, he ran this one hard.
Are a little bit warm. Not bad. Not bad. ESCs are cool.
No, you can leave your fingers on these motors. Like, they're...
Yeah. Wow, dude.
They may be 120 degrees on those motors, which they have a capability of 200 degrees. So we are way in the green there.
Okay, on that flight, you know, we're still testing this thing out. It's not tuned. With that said, I think that we are about 90% there on the tune. It could be locked in a bit further, but I was trying to get a little bit crazier with it, do some more rolls and flips and stuff and see if I had much bounce back, which I don't, which is really promising. I can't wait to, until I get this thing tuned, I get...
Fire ants, sorry.
What? Fire ants?
Yeah,
oh,
dude,
damn it.
Here, okay.
Sorry about that interruption. I got sandals on and I got into a bed of fire ants.
Here in Spring, Texas, we have fire ants. They're freaking horrible. Anyways, I can't wait until I get more comfortable with this thing. And really, you know, open it up and see what this can do, because I can tell you what, for a track racer, if you're going through gates, this is ideal.
It yeah, is just unbelievable. Just watching it. Now, I didn't get to fly it. We didn't have enough battery packs, but just watching it and seeing how quick it could change directions was way faster and way more precise than I've ever seen, you know, your typical four motor X class do. So it's looking really promising.
It's looking really awesome. Promising. I'm so juiced right now. That's awesome. Let's fill the batteries. Batteries are good too.